And so for every immigrant, I think there is a very specific set of images about America that, you know, are our American dream. And so for me, my American dream is the opening sequence of the CBS miniseries Dallas. But what I remember more than anything else was the energy, the optimism, the vitality that America represented. You know, maybe it was a little vulgar, but it was dynamic. There was a sense of great fun about it. And sometimes when I look at the current political climate, what I worry about is, more than anything else, that the sense of optimism, of adventure, has been lost. The more optimistic candidate has won until now, right? And that, to me, represents something that's sad about where we are as a country. And one of our tasks, it seems to me, is to rekindle that. Think about presidencies. They are still marked by words. So you think about Franklin Roosevelt saying, you know, you have nothing to fear but fear itself. Or Kennedy saying, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. And through it all, the one thing that has given me hope and given me a sense of optimism is the thing I noticed about America when I first came that really was special, was not the American state, but American society. The extraordinary ability of people in communities everywhere to rise up to the challenge of dealing with the problems that their community faced. Groups like this one, right? And I think I'm not the first immigrant to notice this. In 1831, Alexis de Tocqueville, this French aristocrat, visits the United States, supposedly to write a report on American prisons. But he goes back to France and writes this magisterial book, Democracy in America. And what he notes is almost unique and certainly highly distinctive about America was what he called these intermediate associations, these groups that would come out of society to respond to society's problems. He has a section in it where he says, there's this extraordinary thing that happens in America. When a town thinks they want a choral society, they don't look to the government to create a choral society, they just up and found one. When they feel they need a library, they create one. When they feel they need any kind of solution to a problem, they don't look somewhere else, they just try to solve it. And when I think about literacy partners, it seems to me that you represent Tocqueville's idea and ideal of America so wonderfully, because really this is an extraordinary need. This is a problem that you have identified, and you didn't look around for some government program. You didn't ask yourself who's going to solve this. You just set about solving it in this creative, effective way that has survived and thrived and prospered. There still is an awful lot going on in the United States at the local level, at the city level, at the state level, that is extraordinary. And much of it comes from the richness and generosity of American society, all of which is a very long-winded way to say thank you all for doing what you do for Literacy Partners. Thank you.